Now, after you've installed the AF server, whether it's installed on one machine or spread across two machines, as I showed we were able to do, either way, you're going to have to install the AF client at that point. And the AF client has its own executable. It's going to be an installation that's on the same media where you got your AF server install. And its primary purpose is to install this PI System Explorer. Now, you'll notice there are some other things that are installed as well, like an SDK, a software development kit, some common controls, and some documentation. But, you know, primarily, most people's user interface is going to be this PI System Explorer when it comes to managing AF. Now, don't confuse, when we say AF client, don't confuse that with the PI clients like PI Process Book and PI Data Link that actually make use of AF. Those things, of course, are separate applications, and we do support AF through them. The AF serves as a kind of a search mechanism and a navigation tool. But the AF Explorer is the primary client that we're installing at this juncture here. Now, the AF client can be installed on any machine that has access to the AF server. So in this case, I happen to have put the AF client on the same computer that's running SQL Server, which is, in my instance, a different server than the one that's running the AF server. So this is actually going across the network to communicate with the AF server, and that's just fine. You can put this anywhere. Now, the other point I'd like to make is that when you do this installation, well, since we need to connect to the AF server, we are going to prompt you for the name of that AF server. And so that's what we see during the installation. We're going to be prompted for the AF server. Now, this is not the same thing as the PI system database or the PI server. And when you run this, we suggest you just run the typical installation. The only difference between typical and custom is with custom, you can choose to omit the documentation if you prefer. Just so you know, during the install, we are going to check to see if the PI SDK, that's the software development kit, is installed on this machine, and we will go ahead and install it if it's not there, or go ahead and upgrade it if it is there. Now, that's the second time I've mentioned SDK. I mentioned the AF SDK is installed as part of this, and then I mentioned the PI SDK. SDK is a software development kit. It's primarily for the use of programmers who are writing applications to run against these. So if you're an end user, you can just ignore all that about SDKs.